Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I am out today and enjoying this beautiful sunshine, and I wanted to bring something to you that I had done over the summer. It was a result of a trip that we wanted to take out west, and I didn't have enough room for everything. So I got to kind of brainstorming some ideas, and I got to looking and trying to figure out something that was going to be waterproof that I could just put soft storage items. And what I mean by soft storage items is clothes bags, sleeping bags, pillows, blankets, even maybe a few things in a hard case that really wouldn't hurt anything, if that makes sense. So what I came up with is a bag that would actually sit underneath of my bed rack. There's a lot of voided space there, and I thought if I could put a bag there, I could put a bag maybe between my hard tonneau cover and my bed rack. Now, so here's what I came up with. I came up with a soft-sided shell bag that I actually designed to fit between the bed rack and the height of the bed rack and the tonneau cover. And it actually sits right on this hard tonneau cover. Now, I have a backflip hard tonneau cover, and I believe if I looked it correctly on their website, it can support 800-900 pounds. So I knew that anything that I was going to put in this bag, as far as sleeping arrangements and clothes bags and anything soft like that, was never going to exceed what the tonneau cover could actually handle. So when I designed it, I wanted to be able to put this on quickly and take it off quickly, depending on what trip we were going to be going on, or if I was just going to be driving around town. I could take the tent off, take the bag off, and basically all my camping gear could stay in the back where it was locked up and nobody was going to be able to access it. Now, I went and seen someone that can actually put like boat covers on. So they had the material that I was kind of looking for. So what I did is I just designed this to fit there, and I believe I only made it 36 inches deep. And I did that so I could actually put the tailgate up and be able to reach in the back of this bag. When I first designed it, I really wanted the zippers to go all the way around the front of this because I wanted to be able to flip this down and be able to access every little nook and cranny on the inside of this bag. But when the individuals put it together, they just basically did a smaller zipper here. Now this works. It's a little harder to get bigger items in and out of. So I think I would probably change that in the future. And when you unzip the bag, the flap just comes down and it lays here. And then you can see that I have, some sleeping bags in here, you know, so I can stuff stuff in there and as I need to. And this bag is not 100% waterproof. It is probably 99% waterproof. But considering it sits underneath of the rooftop tent, and even going down the road, I haven't experienced anything getting wet. However, when you're looking through the bag, you can kind of see a little daylight through there where they have stitched things up. I don't think that's a great concern. We didn't have any problems with anything getting wet, and this thing has seen about 7,000 miles on the back of this truck with all kinds of stuff in it over the past year. So it works really well. Now, the biggest problem I ran into with the bag is once I got it in here, it was, because it's soft-sided, it wanted to collapse on itself. So the solution to that would have been probably to sew in some sort of support. Maybe some pockets all the way around it to give it some support on both sides, something that could have been folded up pretty easily, and actually sewn that right into the sides of the bag. And I think that would have worked okay, but because I didn't really put that into the design, what I ended up doing is going to the hardware store and getting PEX line. And I just bought some cheap PEX line and just built an interior skeleton for the inside of this bag to kind of give it some structure so it's not collapsing on itself. I looked all over the internet for a bag like this, and a lot of the rooftop style bags that you see for luggage and those kind of things, they had big flaps, or they had the zip from the top. And because I'm putting it in here between the bed racks, I couldn't really access that. So I wanted something that I could zip down from the end. And this really helped a lot when we were in Colorado and on our trip. We could put all of our sleeping gear here, and as soon as the tent was set up, I pulled it out, threw it up in the tent, and away we went. And each corner of the bag actually has a strap, and it just has a buckle. It just kind of loops right around my bed rack. And I think that would work with just about any bed rack. Mine only has four corners. So I come back to the back and it's got a strap and it just straps around here. And then it just has adjustable buckles here. So that way, once I get everything in position and I clasp it, then I can actually adjust it to tighten everything up. I also have on the top of it, I also have some straps there. You can see the straps there. And those will actually go up and over my rails on my bed rack also. And that gives it a little bit of support and kind of holds it up in the up position. So this bag measures 48 by 36, and I believe that it is 11 or it might be 12 inches tall. This bag works really, really well, and we're totally happy with that. I don't always have to take it along, but when we're out and about, I definitely want to take it when I have more than just the two of us going on a trip, when we go with my daughter, or if we're going for longer extended period trips, it's definitely nice to have. Hey, thanks all for tuning in today. We appreciate it. If you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe to the channel. You can do that down below. If you have any questions or comments, please leave that in the comments section. We love to hear from you. Find us at Misplaced Overland on our Instagram. We'd love to hear from you there also. And that'll keep you updated on all the adventures that we're on and the adventures we're taking. We appreciate y'all, and we'll see you on the next time.